Four of them, Silas would eat one.
पाँचवटा हेमबर्गर दिनुहुन्थ्यो मैले चारवटा खान्थे एउटा चाहिँ सिलासले खाए।
You know I'm joking. You can laugh now.
तपाईँलाई थाहा भयो रेला गरेको अब हाँस्न सक्नुहुन्छ।
But really Silas is my brother.
साँच्चै सिलास चाहिँ मेरो भाइ हो।
Because we have the same father in heaven.
किनभने हाम्रो सब हाम्रो एउटै स्वर्गमा पिता हुनुहुन्छ।
I have known Silas for about 10 years and our hearts have grown close together as we've seen the Lord work among the Bhutanese people.
अनि हामी एकअर्कामा परिचय भएको 10 वर्ष लगभग भएको छ जब पनि भुटनिसको बीचमा प्रभुको काम देखिन्छ त्यसले अझै प्रभुको नजिक हामीलाई उहाँ एकअर्काको नजिक गरिराख्नु भएको छ।
Over a year ago, I spoke to you, and my subject was reading through the Bible.
अनि एक वर्ष अगाडि या त एक वर्ष नलिक अगाडि मैले तपाईँको बिचमा केही बाँचो गर्दै थिएँ अनि मेरो शीर्षक चाहिँ थियो बाइबल पढिसक्ने।
And Silas, you said that there was a lady who, as a result of that, read through the Bible. Who is she? Is she here today?
अनि पास्टर सिलासले भन्दै हुनुहुन्थ्यो एकजना हुनुहुन्छ जसले गएको वर्षभरि 2013 मा चाहिँ सुरुदेखि अन्तिमसम्म बाइबल पढी सिद्ध्याउनु भएको छ यहाँ हुनुहुन्छ को होला
I want to share with you a little different way today about the importance of reading God's word.
अनि म आज अलिकति भिन्नै प्रकारले बाइबलको परमेश्वरको वचन पढ्नुको महत्त्वको बारेमा बताउन चाहन्छु।
I want you to understand that people from Bhutan who know and follow Jesus are not a small group of people.
तपाईँले जानेको चाहन्छु कि भुटानबाट आएकाहरू जो पनि विश्वासी हुनुहुन्छ त्यो चाहिँ एउटा सानो झुन्ड मात्र होइन रहेछ।
You are a great and mighty people who God wants to use to change the whole world.
अनि तपाईँ चाहिँ एउटा महान व्यक्ति हुनुहुन्छ जसलाई चाहिँ परमेश्वरले प्रयोग गरेर संसारलाई बदल्न चाहनुहुन्छ।
You did not come to America so that America could help you.
तपाईँ अमेरिकामा चाहिँ यो हेतुले आउनु भएन ताकि तपाईँलाई अमेरिकाले सहायता गरोस्।
You came to America because God knew that America needed you.
तपाईँ अमेरिकामा आउनु भएको छ किनभने परमेश्वरलाई थाहा भयो कि अमेरिकालाई तपाईँको आवश्यकता पर्यो।
I want to challenge you over the course of the next year.
अनि अब यहाँदेखि उताको वर्षसम्म तपाईँलाई एउटा म चुनौती दिन चाहन्छु।
To consider reading through the entire Bible.
फेरि पनि सम्पूर्ण बाइबल पढी सिद्ध्याउनलाई कोसिस गर्नलाई म तपाईँलाई चुनौती दिन चाहन्छु।
I have other brothers and sisters in other countries.
मेरो अरू देशहरूमा मेरो दाजु भाइ दिदी पनि हुनुहुन्छ।
In North Korea, in Saudi Arabia.
अनि त्यो चाहिँ नर्थ कोरिया र साउथ अरेबियामा हुनुहुन्छ।
There are people dying because they want the word of God and they're punished and killed sometimes because they have it.
हेर्नुहोस् त्यो देशहरूमा नर्थ कोरिया र साउदी अरेबियाहरूमा प्रिय दाजुभाइ दिदी बहिनीहरू मरिरहेका छन् कारण उनीहरूले परमेश्वरको वचन पढेर पढ्दाखेरि चाहिँ उनीहरूले सजाय पाएर उनीहरूले ज्यान गुमाइरहेका छन्।
But we have so many Bibles here and yet so few of Christ's followers are reading through the Bible.
तर यहाँ हाम्रो बीचमा चाहिँ धेरै बाइबलहरू छन् अनि अझै प्रशस्त बाइबलहरू छन् तर थोरै थोरै मात्रै विश्वासीहरूले बाइबल पढी सिद्ध्याउँछ।
God gave us the Bible because He loves us and wants us to know His will.
परमेश्वरले बाइबल हामीलाई दिनुभयो ताकि उहाँ चाहनुहुन्छ कि उहाँको इच्छा चाहिँ हामीले जान्न सकौँ।
It takes about 70 hours to read from Genesis 1 to Revelation 22.
यो पढी सिद्ध्याउनको लागि लगभग 70 घन्टा लाग्छ उत्पत्तिदेखि प्रकाशित वाक्यसम्म पढ्नलाई।
But brother David, you say, I have trouble reading.
तर तपाईँ भन्नुहुन्छ होला ए डेभिड दाजु या भाइ मलाई त पढ्नु गाह्रो पर्छ नि।
then you may listen to the word of God. And if you will let Pastor Silas know that you would like to hear the word of God, we will work to make it available to you to hear the word of God from Genesis to Revelation. How many mothers or grandmothers here would feed their child only one meal a week? But you think that maybe you can survive through the week on 1 hour of Silas's preaching? It is important every day to read God's word. The more that we read God's word, the bigger view that we have of God. Because he is a great and powerful God above the universe. Genesis tells us that he created everything. The book of John tells us that Jesus was the Word and all things were made through him. If there was a bridge from Atlanta to Nepal, it would be over 8,000 miles. If you had to walk that, it would take you half a year. But our God created life. And he is so powerful that that light could travel from here to Bhutan and back 11 times in less than a second. Because he is a powerful and a mighty God. And he can save your soul and he can provide for your needs. The Old Testament tells us that man has a very serious problem. The New Testament tells us about Jesus, who provides the solution to our problem. We understand from the Old Testament that man fell into sin, and every man since then has sinned. This sin creates a separation between men and women and God. When Adam and Eve disobeyed God in the garden, man has fallen ever since. It would be easier for me to walk through that concrete block wall than it would be to get through our sins to God. But praise God, Jesus Christ has opened the door so that we may come from our sinful state into the presence of a holy God, loved and accepted by Him.
आउनु भएको कारणले गर्दाखेरि वहाको प्रेम र अनुग्रहको कारणले गर्दाखेरि हामी ध्यानले पुग्न सक्छौं.
Yes, sin is the problem and Jesus is the solution.
हेर्नुहोस् पाप चाहिँ समस्या हो अनि येशू ख्रीष्ट चाहिँ समाधान हुनुहुन्छ.
Some of you think that maybe you're too old to do the work of God.
सायद तपाईँ कतिजना सोच्नुहुन्छ होला कि म त अब प्रभुको काम गर्नलाई म वृद्ध भइसके या बुढा भइसके.
Raise your hand if you're over 80.
या हात उठाउनु जो 80 वर्ष माथिको हुनुहुन्छ. 80 वर्ष भन्दा माथिको को हुनुहुन्छ हात उठाउनु होला.
Begin to do the work of the Lord when he turned 80.
अब हेर्नुहोस् राम्रो ध्यानसँग सुन्नु होला. मोसाले चाहिँ 80 वर्ष पुगेपश्चात परमेश्वरको काम गर्न थाले.
For 40 years he was with the Pharaoh. For 40 years he watched sheep in the desert. And when he was 80 years old, he led the people out of Israel, out of Egypt.
अनि 40 वर्षसम्म उनी चाहिँ फिरौन राजासँग थिए. त्यहाँदेखि 40 वर्षसम्म चाहिँ भेडा गोठाला गरेर बसे त्यहाँदेखि मरुभूमिमा. अनि 80 वर्ष पछाडि परमेश्वरको काम गर्न थाले.
I don't know this because Silas told me.
अनि मैले यो कुरो चाहिँ सिलासले भनेर जानेको होइन.
I know this because the Bible says it so.
अनि यो म जान्दछु किनभने बाइबलले त्यसो भन्छ नि त.
And that's why I want you to read and study the Bible so you know what message God has for you.
यसैले गर्दाखेरि म चाहन्छु कि बाइबल पढ्नुहोस् र तपाईँको निम्ति परमेश्वरको सन्देश के छ त्यो जान्नुहोस्.
In the New Testament, the Apostle John said that the law came through Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ.
अनि नयाँ करारमा यूहन्नाले यसरी भन्दछ कि व्यवस्था चाहिँ मोसाद्वारा आए तर अनुग्रह र सत्य चाहिँ येशू ख्रीष्टद्वारा आएका छन्.
When I look at the law, I see my sin.
जब म व्यवस्थालाई हेर्छु मेरो पापलाई म देख्छु त्यहाँनिर.
When I look at Christ, I see grace and mercy and forgiveness and acceptance before the Father.
तर जब म ख्रीष्टलाई हेर्छु जब ख्रीष्टलाई हेर्दाखेरि चाहिँ अनुग्रह कृपा र स्वीकार अर्थात् परमेश्वर पिताले मलाई अँगाल्नु भएको म देख्न सक्छु.
That's why I love the Bible because it ends well.
किनभने म यसैले बाइबललाई मन पराउँछु किनभने बाइबल राम्रो तरिकाले अन्त हुन्छ.
When the judgment of God comes, I can look back to Noah.
अनि जब परमेश्वरको न्याय अर्थात् इन्साफ आउने वाला छ म फर्केर नोहाको जीवनलाई हेर्छु.
Noah was saved by the ark that he built.
अनि नोहा चाहिँ कसरी बाँचे त भन्दाखेरि उनले निर्माण गरेको त्यो जहाजको कारणले बाँचे.
Jesus will gather his people into his ark and protect them from God's judgment.
अनि येशूले चाहिँ उहाँको लोकहरूलाई उहाँको अनुयायीहरूलाई उहाँको अनुग्रहको जहाजभित्र सुरक्षित राख्नुहुन्छ ताकि परमेश्वरको न्याय चाहिँ मानिसमा नआओस्.
When God's judgment comes, I want the protection of Jesus Christ.
अनि हेर्नुहोस् जब परमेश्वरको न्याय आउनेछ अर्थात् इन्साफ आउनेछ म चाहन्छु कि परमेश्वरको सुरक्षा हामीमा होस्.
We read in the Bible that God commanded Abraham to slay his son on Mount Moriah.
हामी बाइबलमा हेर्दाखेरि हामी जान्दा छौँ कि परमेश्वरले अब्राहमलाई आज्ञा गर्नुभयो आफ्नो छोराको बलिदान दिनको निम्ति.
But he stopped him when he saw Abraham's faith.
तर जब परमेश्वरले अब्राहमको विश्वासलाई देख्नुभयो उहाँले अब्राहमलाई रोक्नुभयो.
Almost 2,000 years later, God the Father did not spare his son, but sacrificed him upon the same mountain, Moriah, also known as Calvary.
लगभग 2,000 वर्ष पछाडि ठिक त्यही मुरे पर्वतमा अर्थात् अहिले भन्छ कलवरीको पर्वतमा त्यहाँनिर परमेश्वरले आफ्नो पुत्र येशू ख्रीष्टलाई बलिदान चढाउनु भयो.
That's the Old Testament telling us what's coming to happen in the New Testament.
अब हेर्नुहोस् त्यो चाहिँ पुरानो करारले भन्दैछ नयाँ करारमा के हुन आउने वाला छ.
You must read it. Every Christian must read it and study it.
सबै विश्वासीहरूले बाइबल पढ्नै पर्छ.
Years later, or years before that, Isaac was born to a woman who no one thought could have a child.
अनि त्यो भन्दा के एक वर्ष अगाडि चाहिँ ईसा यस्तो स्त्री द्वारा जन्मेको थियो जो चाहिँ अब जसले चाहिँ जन्म दिने अवस्थामा थिएन
In the New Testament, Jesus was born to a woman who should not have been able to have a child.
अनि नयाँ करारमा हामी देख्छौं कि येशू यस्तो स्त्रीको गर्भबाट जन्मिनु भएको छ जसले जन्म दिनै सक्ने अवस्थाको थिएन.
The Bible teaches us that God performs many miracles.
बाइबलले हामीलाई सिकाउँदछ कि परमेश्वरले धेरै अद्भुत कामहरू गर्न सक्नुहुन्छ.
He can change people's lives and he can change their eternal destiny.
अनि उहाँले मानिसको जीवनलाई परिवर्तन गर्न सक्नुहुन्छ साथसाथै उहाँले मानिसको गन्तव्य अनन्तको गन्तव्यलाई पनि बदल्न सक्नुहुन्छ.
In the Old Testament, Jacob saw the heavens open and the angels ascending and descending upon a ladder.
पुरानो करारमा पुरानो नियममा हामी देख्छौं याकूबले स्वर्ग खोलेको देखे अनि स्वर्गदूत चाहिँ तल माथि माथिदेखि तल ओर्लन्दै माथि उक्लन्दै गरेको देखेका थिए.
In the New Testament, Jesus told his followers that they would see heaven open up and angels ascending and descending upon him.
अनि नयाँ करारमा येशूले भन्नुभएको छ उहाँलाई पछ्याउनेहरूले चाहिँ स्वर्ग खोलिनेछ उनीहरूको लागि अनि स्वर्गदूत चाहिँ ओर्लिनेछ उक्लिनेछ यस्तो देख्नेछ.
Jesus Christ is the only way to heaven.
येशू ख्रीष्ट मात्रै स्वर्ग जाने बाटो हुनुहुन्छ.
Buddhism teaches that God is a big mountain and there are many paths to God as long as you are sincere.
अनि बुद्धिज्मले के सिकाउँदछ भनेदेखि चाहिँ ठुलो पहाडमा परमेश्वर हुनुहुन्छ अनि त्यो त्यो परमेश्वरमा पुग्नको लागि विभिन्न बाटो छ अनि पुग्ने ठाउँ त्यही हो भन्छ.
Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man comes to the Father but through me.
अनि तर येशूले चाहिँ भन्नुहुन्छ बाटो सत्य र जीवन म नै हो म त्यसद्वारा बाहेक अरू कोही द्वारा पनि पिता कहाँ पुग्न सक्दैन.
I know that's true because the Bible says it's true.
म यो सत्य हो भनेर म जान्दछु किनभने बाइबलले भन्छ यो सत्य हो.
Okay.
छ
You know, some people would think that Moses led a failed life.
अनि कतिजनाले सोच्छन् कि मोसाले चाहिँ एकदमै के भन्नु एकदम हारपूर्ण जीवन जिए भनेर सोच्छन्.
The last 40 years he wandered around the desert and then died on a mountain.
अनि अन्तको 40 वर्ष 80 देखि 120 वर्ष सम्म चाहिँ उनी त्यो मरुभूमिमा मरे.
He never got to enter the promised land.
अनि मोसाले कहिले पनि त्यो प्रतिज्ञाको देशमा प्रवेश गर्न पाएन.
But Moses had a deeper faith because he knew that death was not the end, that he had eternal life.
तर मोसामा एउटा भित्र विश्वास थियो कि त्यो मृत्युले अन्त गर्ने छैन तर उनले चाहिँ अनन्त जीवन पाएको थियो.
Moses knew that when he died he would live again.
अनि मोसालाई थाहा थियो कि उनी मरे तापनि फेरि जिउनेछ.
This life is not all that there is.
अनि त्यो त्यो जीवन चाहिँ जो थियो त्यो थियो होइन.
If we are in Jesus Christ, when we die, we will live again.
यदि हामी येशू ख्रीष्टमा छौँ भने हामी मरे तापनि फेरि जिउनेछौँ.
It said Jesus says that he is the resurrection and the life.
अनि यसरी भन्छ अनि येशूले भन्नुहुन्छ कि उहाँ चाहिँ पुनरुत्थान र जीवन हुनुहुन्छ.
What does this mean but that all believers have eternal life?
अनि यो के हो कि सबै विश्वासीले अनन्त जीवन पाउने छ भने के हो त?
Death is merely a bump in the road.
एउटा मृत्यु त एउटा बाटोको एउटा बम्प जस्तो हो.
Because if we are Christians, we have eternal life even now.
अनि यदि हामी इसाई हौ अर्थात हामी विश्वासी हौ भनेदेखि अहिले पनि हामी अनन्त जीवन भित्र छौँ.
And I know this is true not because my preacher told me.
अनि यो मलाई सत्य हो भनेर थाहा छ यो किनभनेदेखि मेरो प्रचारकले भनेर मैले जानेको होइन.
I know this is true because the Bible tells me so.
म यो सत्य भनेर जान्दछु किनभने बाइबलले त्यसै भन्छ.
His word is true.
उहाँको वचन चाहिँ सत्य छ.
His people should live in his word.
अनि उहाँको लोकहरूले उहाँका मानिस अर्थात विश्वासीहरूले यो वचनमा जिउनु पर्छ.
The Old Testament tells us when God's people were hungry, He rained bread down from heaven.
पुरानो करारले यसरी भन्छ जब परमेश्वरको जनहरु भोकाका थिए उहाँले स्वर्गबाट चाहिँ रोटी बर्साउनु भयो.
The New Testament tells us that Jesus said, "I am the bread of life."
अनि नयाँ करारमा हामी पाउँछौँ कि येशूले भन्नुभयो जीवनको रोटी म नै हुँ.
When you're hungry, don't go to the store. When you're hungry, go to Christ. Only He can feed you. Only He can fill you. Moses struck the rock and water came out for the people. Jesus Christ said that He was the water of life. As you read the Bible, you'll grow in your hunger and your thirst for Jesus Christ. I am a very poor apple tree grower. Silas laughs at my apple trees. He says, "Big fat man, you don't know how to grow apples." But the Bible tells me that one day I'll be in heaven. And there's a river of life flowing out from under the throne of God. And there are fruit trees on all sides of this river. And these fruit trees bear fruit every month.
That's
sort of like my apple trees.
But
I long for the fruit trees in heaven.
The
Old Testament tells us that the priests are constantly sacrificing lambs. They sacrifice them over and over and over again.
And
the priests are sinners too, so they have to have the sacrifices for themselves. The people in the Old Testament tried and tried to get enough sacrifices to forgive their
sins.
But it didn't do such a good job. But in the New Testament, John said, "Behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world." Jesus is my perfect sacrifice. My sins are completely forgiven. One sacrifice was enough. And I know it's true, not because my preacher told me. But because the Bible tells me so. In the Old Testament, there's many, many texts and passages on leprosy. In the Old Testament, if you had leprosy, you were an outcast.
यदि पुरानो करारमा थियो भने देखि तपाईंमा कुनै त्यो गोरकुष्ठ बिमार रोग छ भने तपाईलाई बहिष्कार गरिन्थ्यो
you had to live outside the city away from your family
तपाईं चाहिँ त्यो शहरदेखि बाहिर अनि तपाईंको परिवारदेखि बाहिर जिउनु पर्थ्यो अर्थात अलग भएर जिउनु पर्थ्यो
mothers you could never love your children you could never hug them
आदि त आमाहरु तपाईले कहिले पनि तपाईको नानीलाई माया गर्न सक्नुहुन्थेन तपाईले कहिले पनि अस्वीकार गर्न सक्नुहुन्थेन
sin is a type of leprosy
अनि नवस आ पाप चाहिँ अर्थात यो कुष्ठ चाहिँ एउटा पापको एउटा चिन्ह स्वरूप हो
we are unclean unclean unclean
अनि हामी चाहिँ पापको कारणले अशुद्ध 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 भएका थियौ
but praise be to God Jesus is in the business of healing leprosy
तर प्रभु स्तुति होस् येशू ख्रीष्ट चाहिँ त्यो कुष्ठलाई निको पार्ने व्यवसायमा हुनुहुन्छ
praise be to God Jesus can forgive my sin
प्रभु स्तुति हो कि येशूले मेरो पापलाई क्षमा गर्नु भएको छ
you read through the book of judges and you read through the book of the kings
तपाईले न्यायकर्ता र राजाहरुको पुस्तकहरुमा हेर्नुहोस्
you find imperfect men trying to lead the people of israel
अनि तपाईले देख्नुहुन्छ त्यहाँले एउटा असिद्ध मानिसले इजरायलीहरुलाई अगुवाई गर्न प्रयत्न गरिरहेको थियो
the best of the judges and the best of the kings were sinners
अनि जो पनि जति पनि त्यो न्यायाधीशको समयमा त्यो राजाहरूको समयमा सबैभन्दा असल मानिसहरू पनि पापी थिए
even good king david was a murderer and an adulterer
अनि यति समान कि एकदमै असल राजा दाऊद पनि उ एउटा हत्यारा भएको थियो
His family came apart at the seams
अनि उनको परिवार चाहिँ एउटा पापबाट छुटिए
He didn't get along with his kids.
अनि उनी त्यो नानीहरूसँग सम्बन्ध गरेन.
But he was the best of the worst.
तर उनी चाहिँ सबैभन्दा खराब मध्येको नि खराब थियो.
But praise be to God when the New Testament came, we had a righteous king, Jesus Christ.
अरे प्रभुको स्तुति हो जब हामी नयाँ करारमा आउँछौं हाम्रो राजा चाहिँ धर्मी राजा येशू ख्रीष्ट हुनुहुन्छ.
He never had a sinful fault.
अनि उहाँ कहिले पनि पापले गिर्नु भएन.
He never had did a single sinful thing wrong.
अनि उहाँले एउटै पनि पाप
And if you have faith in him, he will be your king for eternity.
अनि यदि तपाईले चाहिँ उहाँमा विश्वास राख्नु भएको छ भने तपाईको अनन्तको राजा चाहिँ येशू हुनुहुनेछ.
It's not Barack Obama.
Barack Obama होइन.
It's not King Wang Chuk.
Wang Chuk पनि होइन.
It's King Jesus.
तर त्यो राजा चाहिँ येशू राजा येशू हुनुहुन्छ.
We will serve him forever.
अनि उहाँको सेवा हामी सदाको लागि गर्छौं.
And he loves us from the bottom of his heart.
अनि उहाँले चाहिँ आफ्नो हृदयको तहबाट नै माया गर्नुहुन्छ हामीलाई.
We need a good shepherd.
हामीलाई असल गोठालोको आवश्यकता छ.
The Old Testament talks about sheep.
अनि पुरानो करारमा भेडाहरूको बारेमा चर्चा गरेको छ.
Sheep are not very smart.
अनि हेर्नुहोस् भेडाहरू चाहिँ त्यति साह्रो पाठो हुँदैन
Sheep will stand next to a river and die of thirst if it makes too much noise. Sheep will die if they stand next to a river and it makes too much noise.
यदि भेडा चाहिँ एउटा खोलाको किनारमा बस्छ अनि त्यो खोला चाहिँ एकदमै आवाज आउने छ भनेदेखि त्यो त्यहाँनिर मर्छ अरे
Because they're not very smart.
किनभने त्यो त्यति साह्रो पाठो हुँदैन भेडा चाहिँ
Sometimes we're not very smart.
कोही बेला हामी त्यति पाठो बाठो हुँदैन
But praise be to God that we have a good shepherd.
तर परमेश्वरको स्तुति हो कि हाम्रो चाहिँ असल गोठालो हुनुहुन्छ
He will silence the river.
अनि उहाँले चाहिँ त्यो खोलालाई शान्त गर्नुहुन्छ
He will take good care of us.
अनि उहाँले हाम्रो वास्ता गर्नुहुन्छ राम्रोसँगले हाम्रो वास्ता गर्नुहुन्छ
He will protect us from the wolves.
अनि हामीलाई उहाँले भैँसहरूदेखि बचाउनुहुन्छ
Because he's the good shepherd.
किनभने उहाँ चाहिँ असल गोठालो हुनुहुन्छ
In the Old Testament, the Israelites were stingy with the gospel.
अनि हेर्नुहोस् पुरानो करारमा चाहिँ सुसमाचार सुनाउँदैन थिए अर्थात् एकदमै कम्ती सुनाउने गर्थे
They wanted to keep God's word in their little tiny club.
अनि एउटा सानो क्लब भित्र परमेश्वरको वचन राख्न चाहन्थे
But God said proclaim my gospel to the ends of the earth
तर परमेश्वरले भन्नुभयो मेरो सुसमाचार जगतको अन्तसम्ममा घोषणा गर
God told Jonah to go to the Ninevites and preach the gospel
अनि परमेश्वरले योनालाई निनेभेमा गएर सुसमाचार सुनाउन भन्नुभएको थियो
But Jonah was prejudiced
तर योनाले मानेन
He didn't like Assyrians.
अनि योनाले चाहिँ त्यहाँका सिरियाका मानिसहरूलाई मन पराउँदैन थिए.
They were different than those Israelites.
अनि तिनीहरू चाहिँ इजरायलीहरू भन्दा बेग्लै थिए.
They were mean.
तिनीहरू चाहिँ एकदमै लोभी थिए.
And he didn't want to let them into their little club.
अनि तिनीहरूले चाहिँ ती इजरायलीहरूले चाहिँ त्यो सिरियनहरूलाई उनीहरूसँग
And he went in the exact opposite direction across the Mediterranean Sea. So that he would not have to obey God the Father. But God had different plans. Big storm came and Jonah was thrown out of the boat.
र ठुलो आँधी बेरी आयो त्यहाँदेखि योनालाई चाहिँ त्यो जहाजबाट फालिनु पर्यो.
A fish swallowed him and threw him up on the shore.
अनि एउटा ठुलो माछाले उसलाई निली पठायो अनि ऊ त्यो त्यहाँदेखि फेरि माछाले बाहिर पानीको बाहिर उकेली पठाए.
And I don't know this because my preacher told me.
अनि यो कुरो मैले मेरो प्रचारकले प्रचार गरेर जानेको होइन नि
I know this because the Bible tells me so
म जान्दछु किनभने मेरो बाइबलले यसो भन्छ
Jonah finally went to the people of Nineveh
अनि अन्तमा योना फेरि पनि निनेभेमा गए
They were not worshippers of God
तिनीहरू चाहिँ परमेश्वरको आराधक थिएन
And he said if you don't repent God will destroy this city
अनि उहाँले उनले घोषणा गरे कि यदि तिमीहरूले पश्चाताप गरेनौ भने यो सहरलाई परमेश्वरले नष्ट गर्नुहुन्छ
And the people repented in Nineveh, the wicked, mean people repented of their sin.
अनि यो निनेभेमा एकदमै खराब दुष्ट मानिसहरू थिए तिनीहरूले आफ्नो पापको लागि पश्चाताप गरे
And God showed mercy and spared them.
अनि परमेश्वरले कृपा देखाउनु भयो अनि उनीहरूलाई बचाउनु भयो
In the New Testament, the followers of Christ were told to go to Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and the ends of the earth.
क्रिस्टलाई पछ्याउनेहरूलाई नयाँ नियममा यसरी भनिएको छ यरुसलेममा यहुदामा सामरिया र सारा जगतको अन्तसम्म नै जाओ भन्नुभयो
And God has told this congregation to go to Tucker, to go to Atlanta, to go to Georgia, and to go to the ends of the earth.
अनि परमेश्वरले यो टक्करमा बसेको मान्छेहरूलाई एटलान्टामा जानु त्यहाँदेखि सारा जर्जियामा जानु सारा संसार भनि जानु भन्नुहुन्छ
With the good news of the gospel. The word gospel means announcement of victory. God's grace is victorious, and those of us who follow Him live in victory. So I challenge these new Christians, many who were just baptized, and the older Christians. Get a universal vision for the gospel. Preach the gospel to your friends and to your neighbors. Send out missionaries to other areas. Pray for the Christians in other countries. It's better than the American dream.
अनि अमेरिकाको जुन सपना छ त्यो भन्दा असल त्यहाँनिर छ
The American dream says if you work hard, save your money, you can have a nice car and a nice house.
अनि अमेरिकाको सपना भन्नेले चाहिँ के भन्छ भने यदि तिमीहरूले परिश्रम गर्यो अनि पैसा बचायो भने राम्रो कार पाउनेछ राम्रो घरमा बस्नु पाउनेछ भनेर भन्छ
For 40 years you can have all of this.
अनि 40 वर्षसम्म
And then you'll die. And you'll feed the worms. Have you ever seen a hearse pulling a U-Haul? No, because you can't take it with you. The gospel gives us good news for all of eternity. It lasts for more than 40 years. Silas and I yesterday were talking to another believer who was from Burma. And we were talking about whether or not we'd ever get to see Burma. Myanmar, whether we'd ever be able to visit. When God recreates the new heavens and the new earth, I'm going to see Burma. Not in this life, but I'll have eternity to see everything. That's the Christian dream. But it's more than a dream. It's a fact. It's going to happen. And this wonderful, powerful, awesome God, promises you this. And he's written all about it in his book. And he's very sad because many have chosen not to even read it. So I'm going to make a challenge today. I've got some papers up here that if you want at the end of the service, I'll give you.
And
I want you to take 1 week to pray and ask the Lord for direction. Ask the Lord if he wants you to read his word. And if next Sunday the Lord has laid it upon your heart to read his word, in 1 year, bring this paper signed and give it to Brother Silas. But you say, oh, it's hard to read some of that stuff in the Bible.
Okay.
You say, but it's difficult to read parts of the Bible. I have good news for you. The Father has given us His Holy Spirit to help us. And it can't be any harder than sleeping in a refugee camp. So this week, I will be praying for you that many of you will commit to take a year and read through God's holy word. And And if you don't have a Bible or don't have something to listen to, you talk to your pastor, and we want to help you because we love you too.
अनि यदि तपाईंमा बाइबल छैन भने या त पढ्न सक्नुहुन्न भने तपाईले पास्टरसँग कुरा गर्नुहोस् हामी पनि केही मद्दत गर्न सक्छौं कि किनभने हामी तपाईलाई माया गर्छौं.
Thank you very much.
धन्यवाद.